If you've always wondered why pee is yellow, well, you're in for a treat.
That was a bad joke.
The typical lifespan of a red blood cell is like 3 to 4 months. And when a red blood cell has reached its expiration date, it's chewed up by the body to be recycled or excreted. Now, the molecule that makes red blood cells red and that carries oxygen is called heme. If you're from the UK, you might call it heme. Too many vowels. This big ring-shaped molecule is known for scaring organic chemistry students, but it's a phenomenally cool molecule too. It has this iron atom held in the middle. That's what carries the oxygen. Anyway, turns out your body can't break heme molecules down all on its own. You need some help from the microbes in your gut. So one of the little intermediate breakdown products of heme is called bilirubin. If your body has too high a level of bilirubin, it can give your skin this alarming yellow pigmentation called jaundice. So to get rid of that bilirubin, it's secreted into your intestines. And what scientists found out recently is there's an enzyme called bilirubin reductase. It's made by several kinds of bacteria that live in your gut. And that enzyme is what digests bilirubin into a slightly different molecule called urobilinogen, which can enter your bloodstream and eventually make its way to your kidneys and leave your body as the yellow color in your urine. Add a little number two to this story. There's another byproduct from breaking down bilirubin in the gut called stercobilin, and that's what gives poop its color. In the first few months of life, your body doesn't have these bacteria or this bilirubin digesting enzyme, which is why newborns are at such high risk for jaundice. You are seeded with these bacteria when you're an infant. This critical function of your body, getting rid of worn out blood cells, it's like a power up that you get after you're born, thanks to some microbes that live in your guts. Just goes to show, every surprising fact has a little pee in it. Follow me for more cool science. And weird science too, I guess.